Welcome all. We are going to start our next lesson, that is the number one. Earlier we have studied about the Roman numerals. That was our first lesson. I hope you have all solved the exercise related to it. Now we will just start to this lesson. Before that, there is a sort of revision we will do from your fourth standard. Now just tell me, fourth standard you have studied about the four digit number. You have also studied about the five digit number. Yes. So now we are going to see further 6-digit number and also 7-digit number. So before we go further, we will see what we have studied earlier. So just now we will see here the board. Now you can see Devanagari numerals, international numerals and in words. So what are Devanagari? Yes, Devanagari means in Marathi. How you are going to write the number in Marathi? International numbers means the number which we are using daily. And the next type is the, we are going to write them in words. Just help me out to solve this. Okay. 2, 3, 5, 9. How am I going to read this number? Yes, I am going to read this number as 2359. How am I going to write them in Marathi? How is 2 written in Marathi? Can you tell me how it is written? Yes, it is written like this. How is 3 written? It is written like this. How is 5 written? Yes, 5 is written like this. And 9 is written like this. So, in Devanagari, we are going to use this. Now, they have told us to complete this also in words. Can you tell me in words how I am going to write? Yes. It is 2,350. Now, we will see the next, that is 67,000. Now, how I am going to write in international numbers? Yes, it is 67,569. So, that only we have wrote over here, that is 67,569. Can you tell me now 1034? 1034. How we are going to write in international number? Yes, it is 1034. How I am going to write in words? It is 1,034. How many rupees do they make? This is the next question which is given in your problem set 2. How many rupees do they make? We are just going to calculate them. I will just show you the easy trick and easy step how we are going to solve it. Now, 20 notes of 1,000 rupees. 20 notes of 1,000 rupees. Right now 1,000 rupee denomination is totally gone. So still they have given you as a question, and this book tradition is old one. That's why we are supposed to solve it, because it is a part of our exercise. So 20 notes of 1,000 rupees, 5 notes of 100 rupees and 14 notes of 10 rupees. Many times you have been using, you are familiar with these notes. You are knowing how they have been seen, how they look. But now we will start how we are going to solve it. Okay, 20 notes of 1,000 rupees. 20 notes of 1,000 rupees means 20 notes of 1,000 means 20 into 1,000. Okay, we will see the calculation later. 5 notes of 100 rupees. How many notes are there of 100? Yes, there are 5 notes of 100 rupees. And 14 notes of 10 rupees. How many notes are there of 14? Yes, 14 notes of 10 rupees. So, and they have asked you the question, how many rupees do they make? We are going to see the total. We are going to do the addition. Before that, we will just do this calculation. What they have given? 20 notes of 1,000 rupees. 20 notes of 1,000 rupees. That is 20 into 1,000. 5 notes of 100, therefore 5 into 100. 14 notes of 10, that is 14 into 10. So we will just see the calculation. 20 into 1000. Are you going to solve it by the multiplication method? I have shown you earlier when you were there in fourth standard, I have shown you a small trick. How we are going to do the multiplication? You can see here 2. You can see here 1. 2 ones are. Yes, 2 ones are is 2. Can you calculate how many zeros are here? There is 1 and these are 3 zeros. So this 1 and this 3, the addition of 1 plus 3 is 4. So we are going to write 4 zeros at the back. Okay, what we did? 2 into 1, that is 2. This 1 0 and these 3 zeros, we have added them, that is 1 plus this 3, that are 4 zeros we have written at the back. We will see here now. 5 into 100. So 5 into 1 we will do. 5 into 1 is how much? 5. How many zeros are here? Is there any zero here? No. How many zeros are here? 2 zeros. So we are going to write 2 zeros, that is 500. Now 14 into 10. Any number into 10, we are knowing it. 2 into 10 is 20. 3 into 10 is 30. 11 into 10 is 110. So 14 into 10, we are knowing. But still, I will show you by the trick itself. 14 into 1 is 14. How many zeros are present? 1 zero is present over here. So it is 140. Can I add this now? Yes. I am only just going to place it such a way so that it will be down to this. And this 140 I will place over here. So can you tell me what is the addition? Yes. 0 plus 0 plus 0. Yes, it is what? 0 itself. 0 plus 0 plus 4. Yes, it is 4. 5 plus 1 is 6. 0, there is nothing over here down, so it is 0 itself. And 2, that is nothing, so we are going to write 2. So what is the total rupees they have made? Yes, it is 20,640. So how many rupees they have made total? It is 20,640. Thank you. Write the biggest and the smallest 5-digit number using 45037 only once. You are going to use the digits 4, 5, 0, 3 and 7 only one time, and you are going to form a 5-digit number. One we are going to form, that is biggest 5-digit number, and you are going to form a smallest 5-digit number. 5-digit number, so we are going to fill 5 places, that is for sure. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now we will just focus on the biggest 5-digit number. Can you see this number? And I have told you one thing, that is only once. You are not going to repeat 7 or 5, 2 or 3 times. You are going to use these 5 numbers only one time. So we will just focus in on these numbers. Can you tell me which is the biggest number from these all 5 numbers? Yes. Over here the biggest number is which one? Yes, it is 7. So 7 will obviously hold the first place here. Second, can you tell me after 7 which is the biggest number? Yes, it is 5. So 5 will hold the next biggest place over here. Later than 5, which is the next number? Yes, it is 4. After that, which is the next number here? You can see if 7 went down, 5 went, 4 went from 0 and 3, which is the biggest number? Yes, it is 3. And the last one will be 0. So this part was very easy to solve. Now, we will just focus on smallest 5-digit number. Smallest means what? You will tell now, teacher. Smallest means 0 is smallest. One thing remember, if you place a 0 over here, your condition of 5 digit numbers will go and it will remain 4 digit number. Why? Because 0, when you are placing in front of a number, it will reduce the value of it. So one thing you should remember, 0 is not supposed to come over here. 0 will never come here. That 5 digit will automatically get cancelled and it will be 4 digit number. So after 0, which is the smallest number? Yes, it is. From here you can tell me which is the smallest number. Yes, it is 3. Now you can place the 0 over here. So here I am going to write 0. After 3 and 0, which is the next smallest? Yes, it is 4. Next then 4, which is smallest? Then 5 and 7. Yes, it is 5. And later will be the 7. If you were doing the earlier method, like if you were writing 0 here, 3, 4, 5, 7, what would have happened? This 0 at the first, it is having no value. So it would be 3457. And I want 5 digit number. My question would have gone wrong. So better, we are not supposed to do this. We are supposed to write it as 30,457. Thank you.